Well, the last time that we spoke around this time, an earthquake occurred. That was on Friday. So let's see what happens during this weathercast tonight. Hey, real-time numbers on the Weatherbug Network, 44 degrees. This is our Scanna site in Ridgeway. Saw a high of 54 there. No rain in the rain gauge, and the wind's currently out of the southeast at about 6 miles per hour. I'm going to slide out of the way so we can take a look at a few more of our Skywatch Weatherbug Network sites. And the next one that we're going to take you to, bringing you to Columbia, Heathwood Hall, after a high of 57, 47 degrees with a east-southeasterly wind at 7 miles per hour right now. The Academy of Environmental Science in Irmo at 47, saw 58 for a high. Again, no rain in the gauge, but we could see some sprinkles during the overnight hours. Pilliam Middle School at 46 after a high of 59 degrees. Temperatures, the story, because what a difference really a couple of days makes. That warmer air mass continuing to surge back into the region, compared to the ice, the sleet, the snow, the freezing rain that we had to deal with last week. In fact, some of those snow banks where the plows pushed it to the side of the roads and in parking lots, that's about all we have left from the storm from last week. We're going to stay in this warm air mass throughout the week. In fact, temperatures are going to gradually climb, even with a weak frontal boundary set to push through during the overnight time frame. In fact, take a look at satellite and radar. Quite a bit in the way of rainfall. Starting to see some rain in the upstate, but that's going to continue to break apart as it hits some drier air over Columbia and throughout the Midlands. And we're pretty much going to see at best the potential of some sprinkles, not really looking at rain potential overnight. So that 20% chance of rain I've got in the forecast tonight is mainly indicating the potential, which is slight, for some sprinkles as this sweeps through. Let's take a look at it on Future Watch. By the time you wake up tomorrow morning, start your morning with Garrett on Good Day Columbia. He'll likely be talking about the front sitting right on top of the Midlands, then quickly pushing through the area. We'll start to see high pressure building in behind it. Our wind flow turning west southwesterly, and as this high begins to push more to the south, well, right here, these white lines, which are the isobars indicating the wind direction, you can see how they're coming from more of a southwesterly and westerly flow, hence the west-southwesterly wind that I'm going to call for. Should be at about 3 to 8 miles per hour. So not really a windy day. Looks to be a relatively nice day as well. And even into this time tomorrow night, we'll still see pretty nice conditions out there. Mostly clear sky, but we will, through the overnight time frame tomorrow, see clouds gradually work back into the forecast. We'll talk about that coming up in the 7 day. 44 at midnight, 43 degrees at 3 a.m. and 41 by 6 a.m. Then through the day tomorrow, looking for 48 by 9 o'clock. We'll have quite a bit of sunshine at lunchtime. In fact, 62 to me, not that bad to enjoy lunch outside. Maybe a little cold for some. Maybe you still want that fleece on or a light jacket. But I do think you'll be carrying it by 3 o'clock in the afternoon at 69 degrees and mostly sunny. Sunshine and 70 by 5 o'clock. 7 day forecast with 70 again tomorrow to 74 on Wednesday, despite clouds increasing ahead of our next chance for showers and thunderstorms, which will come this weekend. And then that cold front knocks us back into the 60s, which is still above average. But the fact that now we're talking about spring thunderstorms to end the work week, and last week we were dealing with a record-breaking winter weather scenario, we are all over the place right now. Enjoy it this week. Some of the long-range models turning it cold again as we head into the middle of next week. Keep us busy.
Does that cold consist of anything else?
Turning it cold again. You got to stay tuned. Got to stay tuned. All those apps out there and things like that, you need to trust us. See, those things only pull from one particular model, and it changes every hour. Our forecast, the real deal.
Well, this is my type of forecast, the 70s.
Exactly.
You know, I can deal with that. I can handle a few thunderstorms.
This is coming from the people that said, I just want to see snow one time this winter. It'd be so nice.
Not anymore.
Yeah, I would
Not
love anymore. To talk to all of those people now. Because this is What's the kind of weather I'm talking about. You know, you find a pool or, you know, a jacuzzi somewhere. Let's call it a day.
Yes,
Let's call it a day. Thank you. We'll still to come.